Tycoon, come in.
So I hope you'll take this minute, right now, and visit this website or call the number on your screen. Join with your gift of just $19 a month, and you can rescue innocent animals from endless suffering. The next minute could mean the difference between life and death for an animal who's being hurt. It's just 63 cents a day, and I can tell you, you will.
Yeah.
several hours.
Look around the bay. There's no boats out of the mouth of the river that I can see. 2 hours past sunset. There's no sign of them. Doesn't usually take a duck hunter that long to get picked up and get back into the boat wash. Unless something went wrong. Starting to worry a little bit. Check a 1220 for a phone number for me. Same guy you ran at 10:40 for me earlier.
Do you read?
Yep.
531.
Okay, great, thanks. Yes, pleasure. Could be that he was out that time. The tide went out. He couldn't get his boat off the rocks where he was hunting, which happens. But trying to figure out what exactly is going on here. Hi, James Pepinetti here with Andrew Green Game. Just, we called back, want to give a chance. Just had Chavis here, the truck. Thanks. Just circling around to another point, like look over this part of the bay, hopefully see a light coming in or something. I'm still trying to just figure out where this guy is and what he's doing. Channel's navigable at low tide, but if you get outside the channel, you get stranded. The only way to get off on this, you'll wait for high tide, which is, you know, could be another 3 to 6 hours, depending on how much water you need before your boat. I'm hoping to see the light of a boat coming across the bay, hear a boat motor putting along, you know, just something to that effect to tell me that, you know, the guy's okay, he's making the plan. You know, I don't know, the boat motor. It's dark out, it's cold, we're down in the low 30s. Hypothermia is a big factor. The guy fell out of the boat, he's stuck in the mud, he's not dressed properly, you know, could be a dangerous situation for him.
I really hope this guy's
blowing up his boat when we get back there. Tide's too low, we don't have any boats that are supposed to go look for that guy out there, you know. Guy's still not back to the boat launch. The trucks and the trailer's still right where I left it. I don't know, but
they really open.
Oh, there it is. Hello, how are you? Okay, are you all right out there? Alright, that was my main concern, just to make sure you're alright out there. You're out there duck hunting this afternoon, or?
No,
I'm not gonna get the boat, there's no waves in the outside, but pressure on my mind. Okay.
Thanks for calling back, appreciate it.
Thank you for checking. Yep. Okay. We do deal with a lot of lost hunters, lost hikers, and a lot of individuals who aren't prepared for these types of elements. It's refreshing to actually come across somebody who is ready for it, is prepared, and he's one of those guys. That's great.
Pool of hunters who shouldn't be out here. And somebody's probably going to be a one
on the ground and gonna chase the vehicle in case something takes off on us. Record right here. Right down that alley.
For us, aside from the safe location, the decoy's got to look natural. We're going to place the decoy in an area where somebody has to look for to see it. It's not going to be blatantly obvious. We're after hunters who will knowingly commit a violation, and so we're going to set it up to match those conditions.
Okay.